All right, I want to do a quick video here on the Nocta 4 core on a nickel laying next to a 12-penny nail. And what I'm going to be doing is I've got the nickel right here laying next to the, don't let it touch, but as you can see, I got it right here. And I'm going to sweep the machine like this. Just about any metal detector will hit a coin laying next to a nail if you're coming like this, but we're going to sweep it like this. And this is a very hard test because the nail is a lot wider than the coin, so it stays in the window a lot longer and it shuts down the response. And small coils help immensely on this. But what I'm going to do is show you the Fors core. I'm going to kick it on. I'm going to be running this in the two-tone, and I'm inside the house here, so it is a little noisy, but I'll let you hear that. Here's the 12-penny nail by itself. And it's ID'ing about 33. Then I'm going to come across this lengthwise with the nickel. And hear how clean that sound is. Yeah, I mean, it's anywhere from 55 to 71. But you can see how clean that is. You won't believe how hard of a target that is right there for a metal detector to hit. And a machine I'll show you just how hard it is to hit is going to be the Deus. Which the Deus is at a disadvantage because it doesn't have the small coil. Yet this big coil does see a lot of targets that other machines with small coils can't see. But I'm going to be in my Iron Man program. And I got my disc set at 6. Let it come on here. All right, I'll go across the nail. Wait a minute, did I not? Let me turn that back. I think I turned the speaker off. Hang on. Let me do this again. Yes. All right. Yeah, there it is. All right, I'll go across the nail. And it's reading 5. And I got my disc on 6. So, okay, here's the nail and the nickel on that same test. And this test ain't to make the Deus or any other machine look bad. It's just showing you how hard it is to hit that nickel. Now watch. See, you can hit it like this. But right here. Very hard. Now, if it had a small coil, things would even up a whole lot. Another small coil machine to use is over here on the T2. So let me run the T2. I'm going to have the T2 in two-tone. 2+. Here's the nail. And here we go, the nickel. See how it tries? So this is how much better a small coil can do. Now remember, this one here is just like the Nocta 4 core. It's breaking the tone at 40. So 0 to 40 is low tone. 41 to 99 is going to be your high tone. See how it tries to come in there? You need to get it one way sometimes. But that's what I'm trying to say on that Nocta. It's got a lot better resolution on working the iron. That's what I'm seeing in the iron with that little coil. That's a unique coil. Look at this coil. It's 4.7 right here in the width, and it's 5.3 here, so it's got a little bit of an oblong shape. I don't know if there's anything special going on with that coil or what, but now I can take and put this coil right here on the Nocta, and it acts just like the 9-inch on the dais. It won't hear, just grunts on it. But, I mean, same thing on the T2. I put the 7x11 on it, which is a 7x11. It's just going to grunt continuously, and you'll never hear it. But you can see when we're dropping down to these small coils, this small coil here has great depth. And at the same time, it's doing something that another machine would need the tone to break dead on the nail to get, you know, that nickel. And then it'd be very iffy if it would. I can take the T2 and put it in one tone and break it right on the nail. And more likely it's going to start hitting. But that's because you're getting that resolution and you've got a small coil. This one doesn't have the resolution. But one thing you'll notice, and it's what I'm leaning toward, is listen to this nail. It's bleedy. It's got a bleedy sound to it, so it's not rejecting that nail as well as the T2 does. Listen to the T2 on this with the 5-inch coil. I'll run it up here on 2-tone. See, T2's just got a good solid grunt. And that's what the problems are when you don't have audio that's roly-blendy. It makes it hard to hear things. You can see it on this test right here with this nickel. So the Nocta has a roly blendy type audio, and it helps overpower the 40 tone break or the 40 disc break. So I just thought I'd show you that, and you won't believe how many targets I'm pulling with that little coil right there in iron. I mean, you can see, I mean, nothing wrong with it. Dais, I love it. Great machine. I mean, super machine. Nothing wrong with the T2, super machine. If you got one, be happy you got it. But what I'm saying is another tool. That's what I'm trying to say. It's another tool to work in amongst the nails, iron, things like that. This is a very tight coil for some reason. I can take a large piece of iron, we'll have it in here, still hear a small target coming up toward it. Most machines, even with a small coil, it bleeds into the side of the coil and messes you up. This one doesn't do that. I mean, it does, but it's not as, should I say, aggressive, invasive into the coil, the big pieces of iron. So, I mean, Nocta's built good, but right here, I mean, it's another tool for working in iron, looking for little small things. This coil is unreal what it pulls out of iron. I'm talking about spots you just can't get nothing out of. It'll go in there. I ain't doing nothing great with it, but it's still digging targets. Yeah, and that's important to me because it digs targets. So I'm not trying to knock any machine or whatever. It's just another tool. All machines have their place. You know, these modern machines, all of them's phenomenal anyway. But I just wanted to show that. And grab your machine, go out and play with a nickel, a 12-penny nail and a nickel. And you'll see what I'm talking about when you lay it like that. And that's the reason this coil is here in these few more targets. I shouldn't even say few, more targets. Just put it like that. It's here in more targets than iron. And you'll see because of this resolution it's got right here. Okay.